Aside from being the father of modern-day Satanism, Aleister Crowley was also the father of something else.
In September of 1924, Aleister Crowley was in France, allegedly having an affair with Miss Pauline Pierce.
She later left and went back home to America where, 9 months later, she gave birth to her daughter, Barbara. Barbara, Crowley's daughter from lover Pauline Pierce, would later marry a man named George and change her last name to Bush. Together, they gave birth to George W. Bush. The grandson of Aleister Crowley. Being George W. Bush's grandfather, from his mother's side, it seems that Aleister Crowley wasn't the only grandfather with dark ties. George W. Bush's grandfather, from his father's side, Prescott Bush, was the first member of the family to be inducted into the secret society, Skull and Bones.
Doctrines and then placed into positions of power to carry out the agenda of the older secret societies.
The ratio of Skull and Bones members who go on to significant positions of power, either in front of the camera or behind it, is enormous. The Skull and Bones Society does not operate in isolation. It is a strand within the greater web, and an important one in America. Presidents are not elected by ballot, they are selected by blood.
A secret society with deep ties with the Freemasons and the Church of Satan. This position was inherited by his son, George H.W. Bush.
Society seems to be particularly important for bringing American elite bloodline young people into the web and being initiated into the web. The reason that it is so secret is because if the people of America realized what its elite presidents of the future get up to, they'd realize that they live in anything but the land of the free.
George H.W. Bush's nickname when he was in Skull and Bones was May God, the title belonging to one of the great destructors of the end times. His position in Skull and Bones was then inherited by his son, George W. Bush.
Skull and Bones, the secret society. It's so secret we can't talk about it.
What does that mean for America?
The conspiracy theorists are going to go,
oh, shit, they are. I don't know. I can see the word.
Number 322.
You both were members of Skull and Bones, a secret society of Yale. What does that tell us?
Not much, because it's a secret.
Generations of the Bush family are admitted members of this occult organization, whose logo was the symbol of death. Perhaps now we can see why the Skull and Bones logo has become so widespread today. satanic agenda that lies amongst some of the world's most powerful people? The rabbit hole is ever so deep.
Back in the ancient world, these Phoenician, Canaanite, Babylonian bloodstreams, which have merged to become the controlling force in the world, they worshipped a deity called Moloch or Molech. It was a deity that was an aspect of Nimrod, who keeps coming up everywhere, of course. And what they used to do is sacrifice children to Moloch or Molech. They put them through the fire. And in the Old Testament, you see prophets condemning the people for putting their children through the fire to Moloch or Molech.
Some of these rituals consist of recreations of old ceremonies that have been practiced for centuries.
And what you're looking at here, staggeringly, is a group of people, some of the most famous people in America, in long gowns. Behind them there, you see a 40-foot stone owl.
The god Moloch is usually represented as an owl that ancient pagans used to worship. Like Baphomet, Moloch was another of the manifestations of Satan. In the year 2000, independent journalist Alex Jones had uncovered one of the darkest secrets being hidden in the world today. In Southern California lies the headquarters of secret society, the Bohemian Club, known as the Bohemian Grove. Externally, it is portrayed as a nature retreat where members come yearly to relax. However, when Alex Jones infiltrated this retreat with a hidden camera, he uncovered what was really going on. It is important to note that most United States presidents, as well as banking CEOs and other influential figures worldwide, attend this retreat every year. In this image taken in 1967, we see both presidents, Ronald Reagan and Richard Nixon, attending this retreat before either of them entered the presidency. But what is it that attracts members to this retreat every year? One ritual that members admit to attending is called the cremation of care, a ritual that is meant to symbolize the removal of care from the minds of the members, a way to relax from the responsibilities of the world, if just for one night. But what goes on in this ritual? What is the method that these people use to relax? The following footage that was filmed in Bohemian Grove by Alex Jones is not for the weak-hearted, but it is essential to understand how deep the link is between our leaders and Satan, how dedicated they are to elevating his status.
Midsummer sets us free.